Good morning. Welcome to the Green Valley Parkinson's Support Group exercise class. If you're joining us on YouTube for the first time, you'll need a straight back chair without arms, a pair of light hand weights, a tennis ball. Yeah, that's what we use. A larger ball and some water. We start in a seated position. We'll end up in a seated position, but we do stand. So before you get started, make sure you have all those things and that you have plenty of room, because once you put those hand weights in your hands, you're not gonna knock down your living room lamp and so on. So
yeah,
let's get started. Toward the front of the chair is where we sit with our feet flat on the floor for good balance and apart, about as wide as your shoulders and hips. Focus on something in front of you, about eye level or a bit above. So take a deep breath through the nose and out slowly through the mouth. Again. And out. Bow the head, relaxing the shoulders, and lift the head toward the ceiling, relaxing the jaw, the mouth opens, and center. Looking forward, listen to your shoulder, and then to the other shoulder. Center and down again for a circle. The other way. It ends in that position with a head bow and look up, mouth opens, and center. Turn just your head to look over your shoulder. Nod at your neighbor, the head up and down. Good job. And now to the other side, maybe someone over there, nod your head. Perfect. Again, we look forward, roll the shoulders. Hi, Cindy. Change direction. Good. And shoulder shrugs up and down. Lift them as high as you can. Like, I don't know, Anne, it just seems right. The arms are out, those shoulders relax. Move your fingers. Yeah. Good. And then extend them out, tapping each finger to the thumb. You guys are pretty close together over there. Scratch. Work the joints in your hands. Make a fist. Ooh, don't get in a fight with her. Squeeze. Good. And out. A wrist roll. Two, three, four, five. Reverse it. Five, four. Use your outdoor voice.
Two, one.
And some small circles. Please don't hit your neighbor. Change direction, make it slightly larger, working the shoulder. Work it again with that full range of motion. Yeah, and they end here, just to change direction. One more time, Mary, and we're gonna keep those arms overhead, reaching up for one, and two, and three. Look up, four, and one more.
Five.
The arms. Return to the side with a flexed hand. Bring it in, push it out. Two, three, four, five. And they come down, resting those hands. I saw that. So lean into that bent elbow for a side stretch. Oh, that feels good, yeah? And then to the other side, first reach up and then over. Beautiful. Cross the arms over your chest, twisting the torso as far as you can, focus on something and hold. And then to the other side. And bring it back to center, placing the hands on the chair. The weight will shift, the opposite hip is lifted up. And two.
And three.
If you don't help, we do more.
Four.
And one more.
Five.
Take it right into a march. Your arms moving, your knees lifting. Smiles are optional. Good job. sitting far away from the back of the chair with good posture. Yeah. And we're going to slow that down a little bit. We end right here. The arms are dropped, torso pulled up, and it's heel taps, alternating feet out and in. Good. Four.
Five.
Six. Let's do one more. Seven. And we end here with our feet again. Shoulders, hips, knees, and feet, they're in line, and you're sitting tall in the chair, rocking onto the ball of the foot and the heel, back and forth, pumping blood into those lower extremities. Yeah, maybe you wake up and your ankles are a little tight. I know I have that feeling sometimes. One up, one down. Excellent job. And we come back to this position. So we're gonna grab the weights, stay away from the back of the chair if you can, working on posture. So we start with a bicep curl. It's that pretty common upper body exercise. So the fingers are wrapped, the elbows tucked, and again, focus on something in front of you. As you lift these to the shoulder, it's one,
two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
And they come to rest. And let your fingers rest too. Maybe shake them out. And Ginger and I like to do a little stretch. Good. And come up, tuck the elbows, focus, lift and curl. One,
two,
perfect.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Keep them, drop the arms to the side of the chair and rotate the arm and shoulders forward. Pull them back, pinch the shoulder blades together. Good job, yeah. And then here, lift one, that elbow, tuck it to the back for a side stretch. See how close you can get to the floor. There it is, all right, good. And then come up. Another name for this one is waste management. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I'm not talking garbage collection. All right, so we're gonna put one on the floor underneath the chair. It's a good place for it, out of the way, and wrapping both hands around the one you've kept, arms up, and the shoulders are relaxed. This drops to the back, lift the chin, and it's overhead extension.
Two, three, four,
yes,
five, six,
got it,
seven, eight, nine, ten,
and down. So take a break, breathe. Second set of 10 reps are up, the shoulders relax, the weight drops to the back, and it's up,
one,
down.
Two.
Yeah.
Three. Four. Five.
Got it.
Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten.
Let's put that one on the floor as well. We'll pick them up in a minute. So we've gone from this good position with some room behind you, sitting tall in the chair, to what we call a closed position. And it's a little challenging with your balance. So feet flat on the floor and knees together, the arms are crossed. Focus on something in front of you as you extend the legs and lift the feet. And it's flex and point.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Keep them up there, toes up. The heels are glued together and the toes are out and in.
Two,
good.
Three,
four, five, reverse it. One,
two, three, four,
five. And they come to rest. Separate the feet, uncross the arms, and bring them back to this position. And why? Because it's good for balance. You know, that one isn't so good, and definitely not this. So we're going to be forward in the chair, a little more of that leg off of the seat as you slide 1 foot forward. Maintaining a straight leg and trying to keep that foot on the floor. Good flexibility she has in those ankles. So the hands kind of cradle the knee. As you reach from the hip, the arms travel down maybe that side seam, but not on yours, Dave, you have shorts. So drop the head and take a deep breath. Good, and come up. Again, reach out of the rib cage and over. Drop the head.
Breathe into the stretch. Nice, Ginger. And come up.
The leg comes in, the other one extends. And reaching forward and down. No bouncing, but pressing into the stretch. Good. And up. That feels good, yeah? And drop into it. Beautiful. And come up. Taking the feet in a third and the legs in a third position is wide. Working within your range of flexibility. If you pull them out too far, what happens is this, and they buckle in, and that's not what we're working for. We're working to strengthen the hip area and loosen up in the inner thigh. So it's here, those fingers spread apart again, and we are going to put one on the inside for support. This one straight up, like you have the answer. All right, so you're gonna twist to that side, looking up at the hand in the air. The other one is traveling down the inside of the calf, trying to reach your ankle, maybe the shoe, and maybe the floor. We call them clock arms, 12 and 6. Returns to 3 and 9. The other one is there for support, straight up. Twist, reach for the ceiling. Look up at your fingertips. Good, Dawn. And then here, the arms drop and the feet come back in, but we pivot on the heel, the ball of the foot, the heel, the ball of the foot, and back into this closed position. Tall and the arms are crossed, reaching forward from the hip, looking out maybe 3 or 4 feet from your toes, the knees open, and all that weight is on the outs. Perfect, Cindy, on the outside of your feet. Mm-hmm. Wow, Jane, you're really flexible in that area. Come up, tall. Feet and knees together, forward with a flat back, open the knees, and all the weight is on the outside of your feet. Beautiful. And there. And back into this position where one leg again extends. The arms are here. Opposite arm reaches for that foot. So right leg, left arm, that's what mine is. And I'm going to reach down. This one, reaching up for the ceiling. Good. But looking down at your foot, and then return to that position. Same arm as leg, looking down at the foot. Good, and come up. The arms drop, the leg comes in, the other one extends. And again, it's opposite arm to leg. So twist, reach, looking down at your foot, that's your focus. Good, nice, Jim, and come up. Same arm as leg. Beautiful, nice, Dawn, and there. The arms drop, that leg comes in, and we come back into that position. I don't remind you often enough to drink water, but throughout the class, have water, and stay hydrated. Reach down, please, and grab these. It's serving trays. Dodge and weave. Serving trays. So the fingers are wrapped, and this is for shoulders. The arms are dropped to the side. Again, the chin is lifted. The arms rotate forward. Well, and like you're holding a tray of drinks right there. And then they rotate back to the outside of the chair leg. And then not too high, you spill everything. No, it would not be good. And then there, nice. Thank you for counting.
Four.
I need it.
Five.
Six. Excellent job.
Seven.
Oh, you do like these.
Eight.
Nine. Last one.
Ten.
And down. For the second set, we'll put one on the floor, keeping one for both hands. Holding it in horizontal position, so knuckles on top. The arms, they're extended, but they start right in between the knee, right there. Tall in the chair, raising the arms no higher than your chest.
One.
One, and down. A little easier.
Two.
Two. Yeah.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Beautiful.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Almost there.
Nine.
Ten. And down. Great job.
placing that one on the floor with its friend. Finding that position in the chair where you feel safe, the arms are dropped, and we're gonna lift a knee. Trying not to lean against the back, but sit tall. With a flexed foot, that leg extends, it's point, flex, point, and flex. Thank you. Three. Just wanted to do any more than 10.
Five.
Six. I can't hear it.
Seven.
All right then.
Eight.
Beautiful.
Nine.
Ten. Place it down and shift the weight. This one is flex and point.
Two.
You got it.
Three. Four.
Slam on the
five,
ground.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten. Beautiful. Back into this position. Take that deep breath. Exhale. Both legs out. One crossed over the other. This is the midline, so they meet right there. All right, the arms are extended, the hands maybe forming a little arrow. We're gonna start with those arms overhead, reaching up first and over for the foot. One. Good, up and over.
Two.
You got it.
Three.
Four. Last one with this leg on top.
Five.
There, and. Again, arms overhead, reach up first.
One.
Two. You got it.
Three. Four.
Beautiful.
Five.
And there, good job. Separate the arms and uncross those feet. We're back into this position. The ball that I talked about, we use it for a couple of things, but it's like never been touched by human hands. So we're gonna work with the tennis ball twice today, and once is gonna be the working with opposition, so it's gonna be reciprocal movement. I'm very right-handed, so if I were to throw forward, we're gonna do right hand, left knee, and don't really throw it, Ginger, just pretend. So it's one, transfer that to the other hand, and again, throw it forward, lifting the other knee.
Two,
transfer it back to the first hand. We're gonna go in opposite, to the side. Forward throw, that leg goes to the back. Transfer it to that hand. Four, good. This one is an open position. Both arms and feet, yeah, looking up. Transfer it for the last one, we'll close it. So we've been doing this for a while, so it takes time to remember it, at least for me. So sit tall, don't really throw it at me, okay? So
one.
Excellent.
Two.
To the side, opposite, arm
three.
Three.
Yes. Four.
Up.
Five.
Bring it in,
six.
Name. One more time, and we'll move on. So tall, ready?
One.
Two. To the side.
Three.
To the other side.
Four.
Make it a big one.
Five.
Bring it in.
Six.
Super. All right. Your feet are back to a starting position. We'll find this later, but for right now, we're just gonna put it right in there. Yeah. The arms are out and the shoulders relaxed. Drop the hands. Yeah, they're just there. And then flex them, the fingers apart. Two.
Three.
Four, one more.
Five.
Make a fist and drop
one.
It.
Two. Three.
Good.
Four.
Five. And they're out. Cross the arms. Rotate the hands so that they fit together. Lock the fingers. That's the hardest part. And raise the arms overhead, working within your range of flexibility. Don't drop the chin as you lower the arms. Good job. Again, pull them back. Drop it down, pull them back, halfway stop, place the other arm on top, rotate them so that the palms are together and the fingers are locked, arms stretch overhead, and down. Two. And down, last one,
three.
All the way down and apart, shake them out, yeah, they're out, with flexed hands, fingers spread apart. Close them, open, close, open, close, open. Can't talk that fast. Talk a lot, but not that fast. And then curl them up like a claw. Everybody make a scary face.
this is what we do in this class. And then can you imagine you're the first time, you're like, this is probably not something I want to be about. Make a fist and circle. Well, if you can't have fun, Stephen, why bother? Reverse it. Good job. And there, shake them out. Again, sitting tall, and part of this is posture, so that arms are extended and it's soft hands, palms up, palms down, up and down. Good. One up, one down. They're both up. The elbows are tucked. The arms extended to the side like a shelf. Maybe they're so far back you can't even see them. That's what we want. Yeah, working that. Okay. One more. Let's do praying hands. The elbows are lifted. It's not this, no swaying. It's just the hands pushing from one side to the other. Good. Yeah. All right, and shake them out. A stretch before we end. Grab the fingers with the other hand underneath and gently pull them down, stretching that hand. Fingers up. I don't need to tell you that a lot of stiffness comes with this disease, right?
Yeah.
So delay it. So extend the other one, flip it, palms up. Grab the fingers with the other hand from underneath and gently pull them down, stretching. Nice. And then fingers up, pull them back. Good. All right. Shake them out. No, I didn't forget. Those weights, grab them. Ginger's like, don't say anything. She'll forget. So we've done some upper body. Now let's do some leg work. So we're going to take that and we're going to pull them out to the edge. Sitting tall in the chair. One knee is up. Now extend that leg. Bend it. Place it down. Shifting the weight to the other side. It's up. It's out. It's in and down. This is two. Extend it. Bend it. Try not to flick it, but control it. Out, in, down. Three. Out, in, down. Lift it up. Straight leg. You wish. And down. Four. Out, in, down. Lift it up and out and in and down. Last one.
Five.
Good. And down. It's high, out, in, and down. Take a deep breath. We're not done with this. All right. So, sitting tall with your feet apart, that first knee, let's lift it up and hold it. Touch the floor and lift it up again and hold it. Great job. Place it down, the weight shifts, the other knee is up. Good. And touch, and again lift it up. And touch. Beautiful. Having equipment failure with my hair. So we're going to be done with this. We're going to put those on the floor. And the tennis ball again, let's grab that. Make sure that they're out of your way. Posture, very important. You're going to take this and roll it between your hands. Yeah, like you're rolling cookie dough, brownies or something. All right. Stretching the fingers, using that ball to stretch between them. We use this in these exercises to warm up our hands and our feet because balance begins the bottom of your feet. So it's best felt without shoes on, okay? So we're gonna make a soft fist, place that there, extend the arm, looking at that ball. Look forward now and take the arm to the side. Don't track it, you wanna look forward. Bring it back. Let's do that again. Don't look at the ball, but look forward. Beautiful. The other hand now has it. This one here. Great job. Don't smile. I don't like that. Both out. They're pretty close together. I'm so serious. Back and forth. Challenge your balance if you want to, and maybe close your eyes. See if you can transfer that ball from one hand to the other. Yeah, good. Open your eyes and place the ball on the floor.
Ginger has her shoes off. Few of you, well, Bruce always has his off.
Yeah,
and you feel it much better without shoes on. So place it on the floor and roll it back and forth, but push down as well. So you do feel that. Stocking feet even. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Stimulating your feet. Everyone should have a tennis ball or two at home for these. So take it to the other side, push down and roll back and forth. Well, these shoes have such a thin sole that's almost like wearing nothing. Pretty much, yeah. All right, so pick it up. Don't leave it there for a trip hazard. We're gonna push it into the chair. We're gonna come all the way back into that chair, feeling the support against your back. The feet still wide. A runaway. Bring your feet back slightly behind your knees, engaging the core, pressing against the chair and feeling it against your shoulder blades. Your hands are here. Pull away from the chair, arch your back, and then again, press into it. Good. Arch your back and press. The chin is lifted. You're looking forward. You're pressing into the chair, both legs out and feet up. Circle one,
two, three, four, five.
Change direction.
Four, three, two, one.
Again, they're to the floor. They're nice and wide. They get pulled back. Say goodbye to the chair. Shift your weight from side to side and walk and rock on those sit bones out to the edge, giving yourself more room than you had, because we're going to work some abdominals. The arms, oh, let's do overhead. Palms facing each other, shoulders relaxed. The feet glued to the floor, lean back, not all the way, don't touch. That wouldn't be nice. And lean back, well, I'd be cheating. And come up. Three, beautiful job, good. Four, go back and hold. One, two, three, four, five. And up. The hands here, that flat back transfers over your thighs, looking down at the floor. Lift one heel, then lift the other heel. Drop the first and second. It's up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, down. Two more. Up, up, down, down. One more. Just heels three times. Up, down, up, down. And we're in a sit to stand position. Feet are apart. Nose over toes. If you had a yardstick, nose over toes. The weight shifts to the ball of the foot. We're going to come up and stand all the way. Good. And if you practice this, and I hope everyone does at home, have maybe the counter or a chair or your built-in playmate right in front of you. Yeah. So bend your knees, the weight now in the heel, back into the chair. And it's not good enough to just be here. I want to be here. Shift the weight forward. Thank you, Kathy. Great job. And up, bend and back down. Beautiful. And up. Look at you, Bruce. Show off. Good job. Two more. Shifting all the way up. Dun, dun, dun. And down. Last one. Nose over toes. Up. And back into that chair, shoulders over hips, fingers apart. They're on the neck and the elbows are out. We're gonna twist, look at one wall, then look at the other. It's a seated crunch warm up. So as you twist the knee to the opposite elbow and up, two, and lift, three, and lift it, four, and one more, five, and there. I'm warming up. Yes, we need the larger ball that I mentioned earlier.
There it goes.
Uh-oh. About that size. So if you had to get out of your chair as well, and you come back, make sure that you sit toward the front. We're gonna hold the ball with just the palm of the hand. Yeah. And the feet, are, again, are in line with your shoulders and hips and knees. Placing the ball on your chest, the elbows, well, they're down and relaxed. The arms extend. Looking at the top of the ball, transfer your weight over your thighs, reaching from the hip. over your knees, over the floor, and keep going, but don't drop the arms, just reaching forward. Good. Place your head in between your arms. Lift just your head. The arms still reaching forward. Come up slowly. Tuck the chin to the chest. Reach forward with the arms and round the back. Lengthen it as you sit tall again. The arms overhead. Lean back. Hold it right there. Great job. And come up. Back to that position. Track the ball as you twist the upper torso as far as you can go. Nice job on this side. And center. Now track it to this side. And center. Perfect. The space, fill it with the ball. Not on the knees, but on the inside of the thigh. The hands are on top, the feet in a closed position, and tall in the chair. Looking forward, squeeze it. Give you a dollar if you can pop that. Hard as you can. And relax. One more time. Squeeze. Ginger's like, why did you blow that up? And relax. Great job. Hold the ball. And we're going to put it on our chest. The elbows are dropped. Again, it's just the palm of the hand holding it, but the ball is here. The elbows are dropped. Squeeze it. And relax. One more. Squeeze. You got it. And relax. We're going to get out of the chair. We're going to use this for some balance exercises. So make sure that everything else, though, is underneath your chair, not sticking out at the edge. Place it on the seat if you want, but make sure that it's not in the way. Transferring that weight, nose over toes. Again, we come up. I'm gonna put mine right there. Kathy, do you need help?
I'm good.
Okay. Standing to the back of the chair, not too close, and certainly not too far away, but arm's distance. Your feet again in that wide position. If you need a chair, please use it. If you don't, the arms are dropped to the side. We're gonna do some heel lifts. So it's up, down, up, working to strengthen your ankles. Three, eyes off the floor.
Four,
beautiful.
Five,
six,
seven,
eight, nine. I'm gonna tell you right now, we're gonna hold on 10. So go up
one,
and hold.
Two, three. Four, five.
Ginger's like, that's it. The weight shifts to the heel and perhaps a little closer, still using the chair. The weight on the heels of the toes up, down, up, down. Good. Three,
four.
Your feet should be hip width apart for balance.
Six,
seven,
eight.
Good.
Nine, ten.
And down. Kathy or Charles, that ball trying to escape out of that bag is scaring me. So when we're doing this part, just make sure that if you look over your chair and the things that we've used so far, they're either placed on the chair or directly under. You shouldn't see any of that, not even a strap or anything, because it can get us into trouble. So we're here, we're gonna do some leg lifts. We'll start with lateral leg lifts. So the weight shifts from center to one leg. It's a standing leg that's soft, and this one is out to the side 10 times. Two, good.
Three,
eyes off the floor.
Five,
good.
Six,
seven, eight, you've got it.
Nine,
place it down, and the weight will shift to the other side, and it's out and in. Two,
three,
good.
Four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight, nine,
beautiful, ten, and there. Shift back to that first leg.
So we're here. Extend it to the back. Soft knee that this leg is standing on. Looking forward. And it's up, down, straight leg. Two, three, you've got it.
Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Keep it back there. And then bend the standing knee and this heel pressing to the floor. That's a good stretch. Yeah. Come up, bring it forward, shift the weight. The other leg is out and up, down.
Two, three, four. Five,
good.
Six,
seven to the back.
Eight, nine, ten.
Bend and stretch it out. Perfect. I see we've had runners in the class. Not me. To the side of the chair. The body on the same plane as the frame of your chair. Shift the weight to the inside leg. The hand here for safety. Slide it forward, but don't look down. We know it's there. Look forward as you lift it up, down, up,
two,
down.
Three.
Good.
Four. Five. Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine. Ten. Bend that knee. Lift it up for five.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Five. Beautiful. Shake it out. We're going to the other side. Too close is almost as bad as too far away. So you just want to be close enough that that hand is right there. So shift, extend it forward, looking out, lift it up.
Two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten. Bend the knee up,
two,
up,
three,
four,
five.
All right. Take a deep breath. Have some water. And that ball that I asked you to keep, it's an option. If you don't want to use the ball, by all means, don't do it if it makes you feel uneasy. We're going to do a little balance right now. So we start at the back of the chair. We're going to take a side step. Doesn't matter which side. We'll do both. Side step and bring this here. We're behind the chair, but to the side. If you're using the ball, please place it on the floor, the hand close to the chair on it, the outside foot resting on that ball. Not hard, but just soft. And if you choose not to use the ball, then the foot needs to feel the floor. It doesn't, we're gonna circle. So it has to go on the floor and draw a circle so it's not hovering around. So I'm going to use the ball at first, if it'll stay by my chair. Bye, Dawn. Bye, Ann.
Bye, thanks.
You're welcome. So arm, the outside arm dropped. Focus is, is forward. The ball is under the outside foot. Outside foot. There you go. So draw a circle. Draw a circle. Good, change direction. Forward, pull it back. Forward, pull it back. Good job. Keep your hand on the chair, lift your foot off the ball. Nice. And take it with you if you are using it. We're gonna do the other side. And on this side, I'm gonna demonstrate it without the ball. So the feet are wide for balance. The weight is on the inside leg. The hand is on the chair. If you put too much weight on that ball with your foot, it'll just sail. It'll just go right out from it. You want to just barely keep it. So the same thing if I'm not using it, this outside foot touches the floor. Think of your foot as a big magic marker, Gwen. So we're just going to circle. Just forget it. Circle. Good. Eyes off the floor. Nice, Stephen. And then reverse it. And then forward, pull it back, and forward, and pull it back. So when you practice this at home, maybe in a safe place, because it's your home, you know what it is, without shoes, and your feet feel the floor, they will respond differently without shoes and socks on. So we're done with that. We're gonna do a little cardio. And I can't back there. Pat, is it an open space back when?
Yeah. It is. Oh, yeah, it's okay. Wide open.
Whatever you choose to do at home, just keep in motion, marching or sitting in place. This is a long one and we're not going to do it. Okay.
I was having this discussion in the council meeting downtown. Rearranging my position on this friend of mine who had a little bit of a breakdown. I said, hey, you know, breakdowns, calm breakdowns, go. So, what are you going to do about it? That's what I asked you. You don't feel you could love me, but you're good. It's in the early morning hours when I fell into a phone call. Believing I had supernatural powers, I slammed into a brick wall. I said, hey, this is my problem. This is my problem. But that's the main thing. You don't come home for this
one. I like it.
You don't feel it for love, baby. Just keep it
open.
You don't feel it for love, me, but I feel good. I was walking down the street when I thought I heard his voice say,
hey,
what do you want me to say? I said, hey, son, that's a stupid answer. Why don't we get together and call ourselves an institute? You don't feel you're lucky about you.
If you don't come back to your chair and you're not out of breath, we do it again.
No,
just kidding. What? No, that's the point of it. We need to keep in motion. Yeah, a little winded is what you want, working your heart. So sitting forward in the chair with your favorite weight, both hands on it, feet flat on the floor and the arms straight up, the shoulders so they're relaxed. We're gonna reach forward with a flat back from the hip, drop the arms between the feet.
One.
And it's all the way up. Two. Up.
Three.
Raise them high.
Four.
Good. Up.
Five.
Up.
Six.
Up.
Seven.
Yes.
Eight.
Up.
Nine.
Do you want to keep going?
Ten.
Not. Okay. Great job. All right. Cool down. Forward in the chair, feet apart, focus on something in front of you, take a deep breath through your nose, and out through your mouth.
Your mountains, deserts, and streams.
Again.
Rise
and let it out.
Spaces.
Again.
And the outlaws I see.
And out.
So
the chin to the chest. drop it forward again, and it's a slow circle. Hit the four positions. As you rotate the head both directions, chin to the chest, raise it and look up. Drop it forward and center the shoulders to the front. Lift them up by your ears, pull them back. Push the shoulder blades, push them down. Palms up, let them rest, and the elbows maybe touch and open, and touch and open. Everyone should be smiling, we're done. Turn that doorknob. One more time. Give yourselves a big squeeze. Tuck the chin to the chest, the arms across. Open wide and stretch. Kiss the other one on top. Well, the end of class, we always do a little face and voice and be animated and loud. A-E-I-O-U is what it is. So it's
A-E-I-O-U.
Go out and make it a great day. Be happy, be healthy, be safe, and above all, be kind. Yeah.